is APAC map 1 of Grand Finals, Numbani. I don't know how to download off of the Yoku site, so this is going to be off the stream, so if the player controls piss you off, I'm sorry. I think that the VOD split up into 5 parts, so I might have to like switch between videos, but I'm not sure if that's true. I just assume that it's per map and not per random. Let's see what happens here. All these sponsors. Their scenario. What is going on right now? Wow, D.Va, where's the UI? Am I watching? Okay, thank you. Interesting. Yeah, let's talk. Defense has no Reinhardt. Oh, they do have a Reinhardt. They have a Winston. They have a lot of tanks. Super tank. Like almost 3-3. It's like 3-1-2. Instead of the Zenyatta, they're running the McCree. I don't know why they would go with this. Like, once Eska dies, their team kind of just falls apart. But they have a very tanky lineup. Almost too tanky. And by too tanky, I mean, like, the only real nano boost target that they have is the Winston, but I don't think Winston's really that scary, to be honest, because Sleep Dart's pretty easy to hit, and because Speed Boost is pretty good, and I guess the Roadhog too, but... I do like their comp though, but neither team is running a Zarya, which is odd, and by odd I mean probably a mistake. Winz is on D.Va. D.Va's actually not too bad against this lineup, but she's an easy hook target, and she's an easy charge target, and she's an easy sleep target, so this is gonna be hard to run, I think. They have Genji. Genji is pretty easily countered by their lineup, actually. Like, the only, he doesn't really have an easy person to kill. If he can kill Eska, then that's good, but... this comp's really hard to execute, I think. Like, they're not running a Reinhardt either. They're running, like, a dive comp with a McCree. I don't see a lot of synergy between these heroes, like, at all, to be honest with you. Like, these four heroes can get high ground, and then, like, AKM and Unko just kind of have to walk up the stairs and hope that nobody kills them. But, yeah, I don't really know... oh, this is gonna work. Like, it's one of those times where, like, this is just like Overwatch, right? Like, if they push in and get a pick or two, then the game is just over. But they shouldn't have an easy time getting a pick or two. At the same time, though, like, Ana nuke is very strong against these heroes. So, like, if Unko hits some good nukes or good sleep darts, like, they can easily win a fight, actually. But that's really all it's gonna come down to. They don't have the best damage, but they have a lot of... sustain. I'm not really sure how this fight's gonna go, to be honest with you. And I can't really help the frame rate, so if you think that the frame rate looks like garbage, it's not my fault. So they chose to go streets, which I like, and they just overload this McCree. But alright, they got the kill on the McCree, that's really good. And it looks like they get an Ana nuke on the Reinhardt, so now the Reinhardt can't get healed. I don't know if I agree with them not just finishing the Reinhardt there. It's a weird fight. I feel like they overloaded a little bit too hard on one target. Like, they overloaded the entire team to the top right, and they got the McCree, which was really good. Like, if they had just, like, lived after that, it would have been fine. But I feel like they should have just been able to burst down that Reinhardt. I don't know how that Reinhardt lived, to be honest with you. Like, I feel like they should have been able to kill that Reinhardt. The Reinhardt had the nuke on him, too.
Happened.
They waste the nuke there, it only hits Winds. So like right here. Good sleep dart immediately on the Roadhog. That's a very big play. I guess the Ana was up on this ledge. The Ana wound up here. I don't know how the Ana got up here. They kill the McCree, which I feel like this McCree should be dead already. The fact that the McCree's not dead already is kind of surprising to me. Yeah, the Ana was up there. McCree falls. They chase super hard for that kill. That was really good play by Eska to force them all off the upper ledge. But then Unko hits a nice nuke here, and it hits the Reinhardt. Like, this Reinhardt right now, Wind should just be botting him down for sure. Like, he goes up top to finish this Ana, but the Ana's like full health. He's playing D.Va. Like, I don't even know if he knows if the sleep dart's off cooldown or not, but he's not getting this kill at all. And he doesn't cancel his thing. Does he know that he can animation cancel the charge? That was really awkward. Now he's just feeding. Okay. Questionable. Whatever. I would like for them to switch to Zarya Reaper. I feel like you want Zarya Reaper in this comp, or against this comp, but I guess you can just rely on Nano Boosted Dragon Blades. Carry you through fights. This is like a weird position to be in, because they're just gonna keep, they're probably just gonna do the exact same thing. Like, they're committing so much to killing Eska, but they need to kill the fuck, they like really need to kill the Anna. Like, the Anna's what needs to die, not the McCree. But you're seeing the strength of Anna here, like, they get nothing. Alright, now they switch to Reaper, okay. Now what about, like, Zarya? Are they gonna run Zarya? No, they're still gonna stay on D.Va? I don't know why they stay on D.Va. I feel like Zarya just makes sense right now, but they're just burning a lot of clock right now. If they get a good Dragon Blade, they can win, but it's still not the easiest Dragon Blade to get. Like, they're over-committing right now. And I boosted Eska. Not really hitting shots, actually. But it doesn't matter, because they still should be able to hold. Did they nano boost somebody? Who did they nano boost on the side of Rogue? It's a big kill, but that's a bigger kill. Roadhog just ults out of panic almost. They're just killing the clock. This is really good defense from Lunatic High. They reset the ults, which is good for them, but Obi might be able to get sound barrier by the next fight. But I think that the switches, like, now they have, I don't know, Reaper's not that good, you know? Like, even Reaper ult by itself isn't really that strong against tank comps. That's a good kill, though. That's like what they needed a while ago. Eska gets bopped off the mat. That's a big play. Okay, Cam. That was overkill for sure. I don't think they needed to death blossom there, but whatever. So all that happened really was they speed boosted, they sound barriered, and they popped the Dragon Blade. And then the Dragon Blade went out, and then AKM cleaned up the Dragon Blade kills. Like, they put the focus, the camera on AKM, but the fight really should have been in TV's POV, because I think TV could pop Dragon Blade. So I don't know why AKM decides to Death Blossom there. I think that was a big mistake, or it wasn't like the hugest mistake, because at least they capped, but I think the mistake from Rogue was just not swapping immediately. I think if you just hit tab when the game starts and you see their comp, you should just immediately walk back to spawn and switch to Reaper. Like, I don't know why you wouldn't run a Reaper immediately. They really slowed down their push, to be honest with you. Like, they made this push a lot harder than it needed to be. Like, the second that you saw the Roadhog, the Reinhardt, and the Winston, like, that's like red flag to immediately get a Zarya and a Reaper on your team. Like, the only thing that Winds did, arguably, this entire time was kill that McCree that got pushed off the map. But I don't even know that it would have, like, they could have done the exact same thing with a Winston. So, like, I don't think Wins contributed much. And AKM was on McCree, and then he switches to Reaper, and then they win the fight the next time. Like, they weren't going to win the fight previous to this because of the ults. Like, a 6 ult versus 6 ult against, like, a 3 tank lineup is going to be really rough for Rogue. But at least the Dragon Blade plus the Reaper combo wound up just, like, winning them the fight. Even without ults, they just Dragon Blade and the Reaper walked. But I think the mistake, or I don't agree with them just not switching this Reaper immediately. Like, I feel like you just should just know that you need a Reaper. It's like super hard to get kills with a Reinhardt and a Genji against a Roadhog, Winston, Reinhardt, Lucio. Like, it's just very... I don't know. That Death Blossom definitely isn't going to help them. But the good news is they have... They both have Nano Boost, so I guess it's not that big of a deal. Miro switches to Zarya, which I like. Wins is still on D.Va for some reason. D.Va ult's not that good. I mean, you can maybe make it work, but there's no setup for the D.Va ult. He's just going to sit on this D.Va ult for a while, I think. Miro on McCree, though. Earth Shatter from Dean can definitely win them this fight. Oh, they got Dragon Blade again? That's huge. Okay, so here's Nano Boost to Dragon Blade. This is an easy fight. Although, I feel like Ryu Zhang like pops his Nano Boost there. And I said this when I watched the VODs from Reunited. I think if you see a Nano Boosted Dragon Blade, you just accept that you lost. Like, you just like accept fate. Get back, accept it. And they're making the mistake here of not just dying on the cart. Like, what is Miro doing right now? Miro's like, look at the cart right now. The cart's still moving. If you're gonna feed this hard, you need to feed on the cart. Like, the cart rolled for free forever. And it's because three people ran away to stagger. And this is like fundamental Overwatch mistakes, I think, from them. Like, you see... What is happening? This VOD thing is so broken, to be honest with you. Because I click on this thing. Then it like brings me forward, even though the thing says 27 and this says a lower number, it brings me forward. Like, I just want to show you guys what I mean. Tavik goes from 50 to like 100 instantly, and I don't know how. Because I wasn't even anticipating him getting the Dragon Blade. It's a reflex, 10%. Headshot to 90. He just hits random spam, 100. Alright, that was that was actually just crazy. I don't know why they would even let that happen. Like, where's the Reinhardt during this? That's really bad, I think, mechanically from them. Like, Tavik's just poking for Dragon Blade, but that was like 30% in some random spam. So I wasn't really expecting him to have it. But they don't have an answer to the Dragon Blade except for the Earth Shatter, so I don't know where the Earth Shatter goes. Yeah, there's no bubble to protect Tavik, so if they just Earth Shatter him immediately here, they would just win the fight. Like, right there, Earth Shatter, Earth Shatter, Earth Shatter. Like, where is it? I don't know where it is. They just get run over. But now Miro's like trying to live? Like, why are you trying to live here? And the Reinhardt too, like, they should both be suiciding on the cart right now trying to get a kill. I definitely think that Miro and Dean could have easily won that fight for them. I honestly think that Dean should have Earthshattered Tavik immediately and they would have probably won. But now that they're not getting on the cart, they're just kind of feeding away time. Like, the cart's still moving this whole time and they're staggering their deaths. So like, what could have been an easy fight, or like what could have just been Lunatic High just pushing the cart when it was at the bus, like immediately when they pushed, they like back up and they just keep backing up. And this is like such a rookie, like low level thing to do, I think. Like, I think the game's evolved past this to where they should know better. This is just really bad mechanically from them. Like, they didn't sell the cart and they staggered. So like, now the cart's rolling for free and they're down two or three people. And Tavik's gonna get another ult at this rate, because they're not even waiting for the Reinhardt. Like, the Reinhardt hasn't been there, so Tavik's back at 70% ult. And now the cart just cap for free. So I don't know what that was from Lunatic High. I think that's just them playing poorly, honestly. Rogue had a very good fight and that was a very good Dragon Blade, and Tavik's definitely playing crazily good, but look at them not contesting the cart still. Like, look at all this free ground that they're getting. I don't feel the impact right now from the Lunatic High Reinhardt. Nano boosted Death Blossom, easy 3k, easy 4k, and now look, he's still backing up. Like, does this Roadhog really think he's gonna win? It's like AKM could have killed him there, but it doesn't really matter. Reinforce has to hit an Earth Shatter here, or I mean, they can win without it, but... That was a good play from AKM, he forced out the whole hog and nobody died. Graviton comes out from Miro. No, it was Winz's Graviton. Akam has boost again, but I think he wants to wait. Why are they? What is going on right now? Lunatic High is like, they're just all over the place. Like, I don't know what that charge was. Easy fight right there. They just waited for the Death Blossom Reaper combo, or the Death Blossom Nano Boost combo. I feel like Lunatic High threw pretty hard, honestly. Like, their first point defense was so good because Rogue didn't switch heroes until, like, the last minute. But the fact that Rogue was able to take the second point completely uncontested, like, you expect two fights generally in the Streets phase, not one. And it was just one long fight that went all the way to their spawn. And then even on the third point, they like kind of took like very weird fights outside the spawn. Like the cart just never stopped until the very, very end. And they tried to like counter. They tried to like play Graviton Nano or Graviton High Noon into, what's it called? Into Nano Booster Reaper. Like, I want to go back for a second. I just want to see their comp. Yeah, the only person that they can really Nano Boost on Lunatic High is the, like, maybe the McCree and the Reinhardt. But, like, again, I don't think Reinhardt's that scary anymore. I think people have learned how to play against the Nano Booster Reinhardt. Like, Nano Booster Reinhardt, I'm pretty sure, was scary when people ran 3-3 and, like, it was all tank versus all tank and you didn't actually have the damage to kill the Reinhardt. But Genji, Zarya, Reaper can all kind of run away from Reinhardt. And if you get an Earth Shatter on a Nano Booster Reinhardt, it's not really that scary. So yeah, like, they're running. I don't like their comp, first of all, and I definitely don't like how they played the entire duration of that, like, game, to be honest with you. Like, they lost the first point, and then they just, like, fell apart. Like, the entire team just fell apart. Like, all they had to do was coordinate a fight on the bus and just suicide their entire team and come back, and they could have at least dragged the clock out. Like, the fact that Rogue finished the map with time left is actually impressive because they had, they, like, brought it almost to overtime on the first point, so, like, I don't know. I feel like that's just bad Overwatch from Lunatic High, or, like, questionable Overwatch, I guess. The ults from Rogue were really good though, like all of their ults worked, there was no real, like the cart actually just didn't stop. But they executed all of their fights really well, like the Gravitons were good, everything was good, the Dragon Blades were good, the Nano Boosts were good. Wonder if there's a player mentality thing? I don't know. Someone's not in the zone, the shot caller on Lunatic High is not in the zone or something. They have Winston Tracer and they have McCree Reinhardt. So they have synergy at least in their composition. No Zarya though, which I almost think is a mistake. I mean, I don't really like Zarya on Numbani, to be honest with you. And I guess the reason why you don't like Zarya on Numbani is because she's so clunky. And she can't really fight very well. Like, I would almost say Mei is better. I'm surprised nobody runs Mei, but some players just don't like Mei, I guess. But, Zarya takes a long time to walk from spawn if she dies. And this whole walk, she doesn't build ult, generally. And most fights take place up here. And Zarya has, like, range issues when it comes to, like, actually taking fights. But Graviton, I think, is actually really good against lineups that don't run Mercies. Which, like, nobody's really running Mercy right now, so that's kind of why Graviton's so good, or just in a really strong spot. But they don't have setup, they just have Earth Shatter to really set up kills. Like, a Pulse Bomb, I think, is 10 times stronger with a Graviton, obviously. But their lineup's pretty good, like, I'm not gonna harp on it too much. Rogue on the other side has no Reinhardt, which I think is almost a probably a mistake. Like, you're running Winston, Genji, Zarya. Like, this is a very strong dive-ish comp, but then AKM has a lot to, like, deal with, I guess. Like, playing Roadhog without a Reinhardt is kind of hard. I don't know. They can make it work, but I think Reinhardt's probably a little bit safer. This is just very aggressive. They have a good answer to the McCree Tracer, though, I guess, because they have the Genji, Winston, and the Roadhog. Like, it's not the worst comp against Tracer, but If Tracy doesn't get hooked, he's really not going to die. He's really not going to die, rather. It's a pretty hard comp to push into, though. Like, you see the strength of the Reinhardt here versus no Reinhardt. Like, they're just killing the shield. And then another reason why the Reinhardt is good is, like, you saw what just happened there. Ryu Zhang just dropped the Ananuke, and it hit, like, 3 or 4 people. Like, the bio grenade just hit, like, 1 million people. Missed hook. And missing a lot of shots and getting pushed off the map. Not the play you want. I think if they lose this, it's 100% because they didn't run a Reinhardt and nothing else. I think that's, you can chalk it down to that completely. It doesn't make sense to me, honestly. Like, you run a Roadhog, but you don't run a Reinhardt. Like, the strength of Roadhog is that he breaks shields. Like, that's why you run Roadhog. So, like, if you have a Roadhog and the enemy team doesn't have a Roadhog, you should win the shield battle. You would expect Lunatic High to run a Reinhardt, so you should run your own Reinhardt. They got nothing done with their composition, and I question the lack of Reinhardt. And now they're switching players off heroes. Like, Reinforce should probably go right in. Now he goes Reinhardt, and they just reset all of their ults. The only person that has any semblance of ult is Tevik and Unko. I mean, the supports do, and Wins is at 50, but they just dropped 3 ults that they could have potentially had for the next fight. But let's see if Rogue actually contests the cart when it gets to the bus. Yeah, I agree. AKM probably should have backed up. I don't know. I just wish that they had a Reinhardt there. Like, if they had a Reinhardt, they would have just won, I'm pretty sure. Instead of a Winston. I think Winston was just a mistake. I don't mind the Genji, because if you're going for the nano-boosted Dragon Blade, you should just do it. It's too strong not to do it. That's a huge High Noon, actually. They took a fight on the cart, which was really smart. Like, this is what Lunatic High should have done the first time. But they got rolled anyway, and that probably comes down to the fact that they burned like 3 or 4 ults on the side of Lunatic High, and Rogue only had 2 or 3. I think Rogue can contest the card again one more time, though. Tevik has Dragon Blade. I guess he didn't use it last fight, or he didn't have it when he got nano boosted, and he wound up just dying to the High Noon. But this is why you take a fight when it's on the bus, because you can contest again. I don't know why you would switch the camera off of Tevik right now. That's a huge mistake. They realize their mistake and they switch it back to him. Sound barrier comes out from Nox. I mean, Rogue should win this fight, arguably, because they had massive ult advantage going into it. But that was, like, really good from them because they took the fight at the bus. Like, if Reinforce had staggered his death anywhere farther from the cart, they might have not actually won this or, like, gotten that ability. Like, you see the thing at the top of, like, 1.5 meters? That's so close. Now they have Earth Shatter to work with, they have High Noon to work with. Like, they can nano boost the High Noon. That's really strong, I think. I mean, anyone that's played Junkenstein's Revenge, I think, realizes how strong nano boosted High Noons are. That's why you should play your Brawls, guys. Yeah, this is yesterday's match. There's the nano boosted High Noon. No, nano boosted Reinhardt. Or Winston? What is happening? No. I'm really confused. I guess they nano-boosted Tevik's Genji. Tevik got 2 kills, and then they nano-boosted Miro's Winston, and then the Winston killed AKM. So this is still Rogue's fight, I think, easily. It looks like the Earthshatter was used too. I don't know who got what, but that Dragon Blade worked really well for them, and that's like the strength of the Dragon Blade right now. And that's probably why Rogue is running it so much, and now they're getting farmed. Oh, if he had another dash there. This is good pressure from Tevik. He's like pushing up really far, but he's not overextending. Just getting his ult again. Yeah, I mean, this was a very textbook example of why you should die on the cart. Nox is going to have sound barrier for this next fight. And that's a huge kill from Tevik, actually. So they're in a really good spot right now, I think. Rogue's playing very well right now. This is a huge defense, to be honest with you. Most teams don't hold the streets phase at all, but Tevik's on like a rampage. Like, Tevik killed their McCree before that fight even started. And then I guess he just hunted the Ana till right now. The camera works a little shady, but they're doing a really, really good job of like playing the map instead of playing their heroes, if that makes sense. Like, they abuse the map. That's a huge, they should. That was a really good play, a really good sleep dart. So now they have nano boosted Dragon Blade again. Like, they have this Dragon Blade every single fight, it's crazy. They can just pop it on him right now or whenever. Ooh, big Earth Shatter to cancel their nano boost. He goes instantly for the Anna because he knows that if the Anna stays alive, it just like decreases their chances. And then he hunts the nano boost to Reinhardt. So that was also very good. They're playing this really well. Rogue's actually on like a different level right now than this Lunatic High team. Look at Tivik, dude. No respect right now for this McCree. Crouch spamming, just going back in. Tivik's playing nuts though. Really good aim. I don't know who's alive right now because his aim is like all over the place and that was like super disorienting, but ooh, that's a shitty end to that spree. But Rogue has High Noon, Sound Barrier, and Graviton, so like they can still kind of win this fight. I think Lunatic High is kind of panicking right now. Sound Barrier comes out. I want them to just Graviton right now. Ooh, that's unfortunate. Although Reinforcing Winds are doing it right now, man. He gets on the car, he switches to Reaper. I like the Reaper switch because he knows what he's up against. Like, now they have Roadhog, Winston, Reinhardt. They're running triple tank again, Lunatic High is, because I guess Miro wasn't feeling the McCree or whatever. No, was it Miro? No, it was Eska. Eska's still on the McCree. But Tivik swaps there, very smart. I think they could have made more of their High Noon. I guess that they didn't, but this Roadhog's just feeling Wind's ult anyway. Like, Wind's just used Graviton last fight, and he's at 80%. So that's, like, very good for them. Good zoning High Noon. It's good to see this. I haven't seen this play. Like, teams haven't done this in a while because the patches. But that used to be a really common thing to see, was team speed boosting a High Noon to try to gain ground on the cart. Wins really needs his Graviton. I would hope he doesn't use it right now. I hope he just dies out, because they're not going to win this fight at all, but they should be able to defend the cart if nobody else dies. Dean's getting a little aggro here. If he had died there, that would have been really bad. They have nano boost. Massive play right there. Nano boost only gets one, but it got wins after he popped his grav. They get the nano boost off right now from Unko. That should be really good for them. That was massive. That was really good timing. And again, this goes, I think that they actually went to times two. This might have been another mistake from the side of Lunatic High. How is it possible that I'm going backwards? But watch. So, like, Rogue takes the fight here at the cart very, very smartly. Intelligently. I say smartly, it's not even a word, I don't think. But the ult situation right now is pretty bad for Rogue, so they pop High Noon here just to slow down the cart. They need more time, you know? Like, you need time, and this is just making time. It's not like the greatest High Noon in the world, but look how much space it gives them. So it creates a shit ton of space, and now they're going to fight on the cart, and the cart is right at the corner. They should just go fight right now. You don't want the cart to pass the corner. If the cart passes the corner, you're kind of boned. But like right now, they just need to die on the cart. So you see Tivik there on the cart, dying. Times one, times two, times two, times two. Okay, times two, it just got to times three. Times two again. I question whether or not that time would have made a difference. Times two? Times one? Times two? Like, it gets to 1.6 meters. I don't know the math, but I would say that it's probably likely that they needed that extra bit of time on the cart. Because there goes the nano boosted Death Blossom. Easy game. So that's really interesting. And by interesting, I mean like it might have been a huge mistake. But that was really well played from Rogue. They did exactly what they needed to do, but I don't know if I feel like they actually took the fight too late, and then Lunatic High just didn't have enough people on the cart there. Like he got so they got so close to capping that that extra times one times two for like the extra 3 or 4 seconds or whatever might have actually been the difference maker. I like Reinforce just charging in, like doesn't care at all there because he's just forcing a reaction. They got the kill on the Roadhog. Every kill is a huge kill. They're gonna get the overtime, it looks like. But AKM. Inko doesn't have Graviton. That could have worked out, but they forced overtime, so that's pretty good from them. That means that they shouldn't get their free minute. The game gives you that free minute sometimes, but I don't think that you get free minute here because they brought it to overtime. Yeah, so now Rogue gets an overtime chance to win the map, which is beneficial, and that's Riot was really smart for. If you go forward when you want to go backward, the bots because the anti-chronological concession of time used in Korean institutions since such was done. No, watch, like, it says 4104 right here, and then I'll click like 4034, you see? And then, like, sometimes it'll, like, now it brings me back. Sometimes it doesn't. I don't know what the hell is going on sometimes. Whatever, man. Or sometimes it just brings me not to where I see it. What happens if they draw? It's probably just a draw. I don't know the rules. It might go to a Koth map, honestly. Like a best of three on like Anubis, or not Anubis. Like Li Zhang or something. Where's my phone? Yeah, I know the rules for the minute, but I was just saying like the fact that Ryan Reinforced went in when he did was just to delay the cart more. Like, I don't think Tivik needed to die when he died, to be honest. But it doesn't really matter. They replay Numbani again? Is that true? That's crazy. So now I would expect a crazy dive comp, like a Zarya Tracer, or like a Genji Tracer, Genji Winston, Reinhardt, I don't know. They just need to get Nano Boost once and win with it. But I expect them to run the Reaper this time. If they don't run the Reaper off the start, then like they're kind of boned. I completely expect a Reaper from Rogue, but I've been proven wrong before. Pocket strat, I guess? Okay. This strat, honestly, was, I think, I don't know who came up with it. I came up with it on Hollywood, but I don't know if someone else came up with it. The idea is generally you push up top. This people have done it. I tried this on Hollywood once. I've never tried it on this map, but it makes sense, right? You push up top with this comp, and then like you drop a Maywall, and then you set up as a Bastion behind it. It's good, but it's very risky. The C9 do this on offense? I don't know if they run an offensive Bastion, but if they have, maybe I'm just dumb and I just never saw it. But the idea is pretty much like you just go up top, you put up a Maywall, and then you set up the Bastion behind it, and then it's like, oh shit, surprise Bastion. But if they don't scout it, which it doesn't look like they scouted it yet, then they're boned. Now TV just needs to put up a wall. I think he could have gotten more space there. That was so weird, honestly. I feel like they messed up their execution really hard. I feel like they could have easily, like, just pushed up. Oh, Insight. That was a crazy host. Thanks so much, Thorin, or whoever that was. I guess it was Thorin or Monty? That's a huge host. Thank you so much. But I feel like they could have just pushed up right here. I don't know why AKM decided to stand here. Like, that was an easy wall from Eska. But that was a crazy... Like, the idea was there, but the execution wasn't. I don't know why they didn't just take the upper high ground. If they had just taken the high ground, that would have been sick. Thanks a lot, though, Thorin, if that is Thorin. We got a lot of viewers, boys. We're doing VODs, though. So now they're like in panic mode. Now they're like, oh shit, that didn't work. But I don't know why you would go to that strategy, honestly, at the beginning of your fight. Like, if you only have a minute 35, isn't it safer to run like a nano boosted Reaper or something, or a nano boosted Genji, or even a Zarya Tracer? I don't like. I feel like that's so risky, unnecessarily risky, you know? Because now they're in such a bad position. Like, is this going to go to a second map? Like, is that what's about to happen? Like, are we about to watch this go to a second game of Numbani? Because I'm not really ready for a second game of Numbani. But I feel like this is a super hard push for them. Like, who are they going to nano boost here? Nobody has ult. This might go to a second round, I guess, of Numbani. Super easy fight for Lunatic High, but okay, I feel like they really threw here in some ways. Skip the second game? Nah, dude, I want to see how they win, because like now, I petitioned, but when the game came out, I honestly wanted best of threes on one map, not best of threes on like 10 maps. Not best of threes on three different maps. I'd rather see a best of three on a separate map, because it like, you can make a storyline on each map. So, like, I'm more concerned with how the teams will come back for the second round and, like, think about how they're going to attack or approach the map differently. I feel like Rogue didn't have to get that risky, though. I didn't watch this live at all. I actually have no idea what's going to happen. I didn't know that this is going to a second map. But, why would you go with such a risky strat when all you need is a minute and a half? Like, a minute and a half isn't super bad time-wise. Like, you can get nano boost in a minute and a half. Like, why would you not run? Why would you try that? That's so hard. That's, like, super hard to pull off. I don't know, Rogue. Rogue's trying to flex here, and I don't know if they're super cocky or what. I guess the idea was, like, the worst case scenario is we tie. But why even give it that chance? Like, why even, like, let it get to that point? I don't know. Whatever, Rogue. Rogue gets a second shot, but I feel like they didn't need us. They shouldn't have needed a second shot. Rogue does not suffer from a lack of confidence. Yeah, for sure. Like, I agree with that. But you could tell that anyway. You want me to just fast forward up? I don't know how long this is going to take. This is cool, though, because I've never seen a tie before. They were talking shit after the game. I mean, talking shit after the game is whatever. Okay. Why do they do this to themselves? Okay, now they finally run a normal comp, or like a comp that I think that makes sense. Like, now, alright, so like, they had enough time, you know, to play the map an entire 20-30 minutes or whatever we just watched, and now they finally start off with the Reaper. They could have had the Reaper last time. They have the Genji now. They have the Genji the whole time because nano boosted Genji is overpowered, and nano boosted Reaper is overpowered. So now they have very clear-cut ways to win the map. No Zarya, which I think is bizarre, and no Reinhardt, which I also think is bizarre, because I mean, Winston's obviously good, but D.Va's just a weird hero. I don't like D.Va. I mean, maybe they like it for some reason. I just don't like it. I guess it didn't work out poorly for them last time, but no, Haxel's on Runaway. I don't know. I feel like Zarya's just better, but whatever. And then they're running the same triple tank setup they had before, except now they have a McCree instead of a Reaper. Wynn says he can't get charges. All right, yeah, it's hard to play Zarya on offense on this map, like, for sure. I agree with that 100%. I feel like there's gotta be something that's better than D.Va. I don't know. Maybe there's not. Maybe they don't think so. This is an awkward camera angle. That was really weird. Now they're overloading Eska again, but like last time they did this, they couldn't kill Eska, and they couldn't kill Eska again this time. You need to like throw everything in the kitchen sink at the... Ooh, that was a big play from Tivik. He needs to live. This D.Va needs to not die right now. Look at this D.Va! What is happening? Why did that work? How did that work at all? That was so silly. That was like the silliest push I've ever seen. Watch how this starts. Alright, I just went backwards again. They went forwards. That was just like the most bizarre push I've ever seen. Like, watch, Tabik goes in like half. He doesn't. He gets the health pack and like runs away. And then Reinforce comes up here to try to kill McCree, but like obviously doesn't because the McCree's got the Ana with him. He also leaves his bubble for some reason. He could have just been in the bubble this whole time, but whatever. Dies, and then watch this. This is where it gets really clowny. Because somehow AKM kills the Winston, which is really good for them, but they're like trading kills at this point, so it's not like the best situation if you're on offense. But watch this. Like, they get a sleep dart on Dean, and then look at Wins right here. Wins is just like, what do I do? What is happening? He finally puts up his Matrix, and then Eska's like, okay, I can't deal with that. And he looks for someone else to kill. And then Wins is still down there. And then Tabik with like 10 HP flanks and gets the kill on the Ana, which is like super good. And now Wins is still up here with like 5 HP, and his whole team is just trickling in. And then like Eska's so confused right now. Like, poor Eska, man. But this was a really good push from them, and Wins made a lot of space with that D.Va, like for sure, that D.Va paid off. That was pretty ridiculous though. So now they have Nano Boost and they probably have Dragon Blade or whatever they want for the next fight. Wins switches off to Zarya, I like that. I mean, he definitely made the D.Va work. I questioned the D.Va, but the D.Va wound up working out tenfold for them. Just spamming to build ult, that's fine. Ryu Zhang has Nano Boost. This is a zoning High Noon. Ooh, that's a big kill. They should just run right now. I don't think that they can fight this. That was like the best possible kill that they could have gotten. Now they're kind of dying staggered. But that's okay. I mean, Reinforce I think got caught. I don't really think that there was any way for him to live there. Huge hook. Okay. Slowing it down. Where can you find VODs from this Overwatch League? It's on Youku.com. Banana Culture's Twitch, but this is on Youku, which is, I guess, the Chinese site. So now, like, this is what they should have done in the first map. I guess, like, they realize what they should have done, but they... Like, now they're contesting the cart super close to Rogue Spawn, and now they're in, like, a really good position ult-wise. The thing is now, it's in that weird spot where teams are just going to kind of hit Q and you're not really sure who's going to win. I like Rogue's Nano Boost combination way better than Lunatic High's here though, because they have the Dragon Blade. But if Dean can hit the Earth Shatter, like, they'll be fine. So, I'm not sure who's going to win this fight. It really comes down to Dean's Earth Shatter, as silly as that sounds. The only thing that can counter Tavik or AKM on this lineup is a Flashbang, which won't stop the Dragon Blade. But it will stop the Death Blossom. I mean, if Wins hits a bubble though, then they're not going to get any kills. Or like, they won't stop this. So the Flashbang is down. That's a pretty big deal. Now the Nano Boost comes out on Tavik. No, it's on AKM. Alright, so they Earth Shatter. So that, they just got dealt with. And that was the best case scenario for Lunatic High. Although, I don't... Why did they just Sound Barrier? Nox? Hello? Okay, so that Sound Barrier was really bad. The Earth Shatter is really good from Dean. They countered that really well. But I feel like AKM also went... He didn't use Death Blossom, though. So now Unko is actually back at 70% ult. They just Nano Boosted a Reaper one fight ago. It was like, what, 10, 15 seconds? And he's already at 75%? Like, is that okay? Like, I feel like that's not okay. I mean, this is post-patch. And I know it's post-patch because there's a Roadhog with the Halloween skin. Now they'll get their own Nano Boost again in like no time. And they won't expect this on the sign of Lunatic High. So Tabik pops his Dragon Blade to force a reaction. This is really good. They didn't actually want to get kills here. Although... Alright, why are they throwing? What is going on? No, there's no reason to pop Sound Barrier when he did, but I like Tavik's Dragon Blade here because it forces reactions out of Lunatic High. Like, they push Nano Boost, and like, if you can trade Nano Boost for Dragon Blade, I think that's really good. But why does Unko Nano Boost here? Like, just accept that you lost. They're really hurting themselves right now. Rogue is like throwing pretty hard. Luckily, their first point push worked really well. But they could have saved Nano Boost for sure there. And now AKM is like, okay, screw this, I'm getting off Reaper. And TVK's like, okay, I'm going Mei. I mean, this is a weird switch, but I don't hate it, because what they were doing obviously wasn't working. But it wasn't working because they were making it not work, not because it wasn't working. Like, it's not like their comp was a problem. It was, they just weren't hitting ults correctly together. Esco's just going huge right now. So now Rogue is a little tilted, I guess. Like, this just looks like tilt. It's not shot calling though, it's like just straight up personal mistakes. I mean, whatever, I'm not gonna like judge them for it, but I don't understand how you waste. Like, all you have to do to win this game, I mean, like, I'm gonna sound like really negative, I guess. Like, this is a toxic stream, right, guys? Like, all you have to do really is force out nano boosts from Lunatic High and then take a fight where you have nano boost and like you'll win the fight. Like, it's really that simple. Like, if Lunatic High doesn't have nano boost and you nano boost a Death Blossoming Reaper and put a bubble on him, like, you're gonna get killed. I don't care what hero it is. So, like, now Rogue is, like, kind of throwing. Like, they're kind of just throwing ults away, and I feel like that's really hurting them. Like, they threw away the Sound Barrier, they threw away the Nano Boost. And every time you lose a fight that you should win, it's, like, another 30 or 40 seconds on the clock, at least. But finally, they get a kill, and they baited out the Sound Barrier. So now there's another Sound Barrier from Lunatic High. Huge Sleep Dart. Nano Boost gets nothing. It's another wasted Nano Boost. And here's a wasted Graviton, I guess. They are just throwing away everything. Rogue, please. They just used Nano Boost on a Reaper, which was okay, I guess. But then they Gravitoned after the Reaper died. AKM was already dead. Or I guess AKM died during the Graviton, but you Gravitoned in your spawn. A big kill from Tivik, but he's gonna die here for sure, right? A lot of heals he's getting, actually, no. So that's a big kill from Tivik, and that might actually be enough for them to, like, push now. Tivik doesn't need ults, he's just making plays. They should win this next fight, though. They have Rose Shadow, they have Death Blossom. There's not really much of a response on the side of Lunatic High. Big Rose Shadow from Reinforce. That's a really big play from Reinforce, actually. But yeah, Tivik's just running at them. He's playing really well. Ooh, big. That's a. It's like, now they're doing that. Why do you waste Nano Boost here? He doesn't need this shit. Oh my god. Unko is kind of wasted at least like two or three this entire map. That was a really good Sound Barrier. But I feel like they shouldn't have needed it. And I feel like that Nano Boost was really bad. But, I mean, you can build Nano Boost pretty fast, I guess, is the argument that you can make. But you'd probably want it right now. But yeah, Reinforce went crazy there. So here comes the Nano Boosted Death Blossom from Li Taizhen, but they scouted it somehow? They know it's coming. Ooh, AKM. Bad shots. That was a really big play from AKM. What is one thing a player can focus on that is most important, most useful for or for improvement? Probably positioning or ult timing management. What's crazy is that they didn't actually win this push because of ults. Like, they just won this push because they played better. Like, they just outskilled them the entire way throughout this push. Like, that's Nano Boost, or that those headshots from AKM were crazy. AKM is like turned it on right now. Okay, so finally. But I feel like Unko wasted way too many Nano Boosts throughout this entire fight, and they probably could have shaved off like 2 or 3 minutes from that time if they had just used it faster. Or like use them better, I guess. Not even faster, just better. Like more timely manner. It's a strange world we live in where that works. I think Tivik though played super well, and AKM definitely just played super well. I mean, everyone played well, but their ult usage was actually pretty poor. Like, that D.Va play at the beginning was insane, too. Like, why did that work? You don't even know why it worked, but it did work. The best part of the series was seeing Tuvik stand next to Reinforce. Reinforce is like 6'7", I think. Like, I'm 6'4", so when I see people taller than me, it kind of makes me like confused or like, I don't want to say insecure, it's just like bizarre. Like, I'm like, wow, there's someone taller than me here. So I'm kind of excited to eventually run into Reinforce. I don't know if he'll be at BlizzCon, but I hope I see him, because I always feel weird when I see people taller than me. He's 6'9", is that true? I don't think he's 6'9". He's 6'9"? I thought it was like 6'7", 6'8". It was mechanics carrying them past bad decisions. I mean, they finished the map. It wasn't the best time, but they secured their second half, at least, if like they don't have a good defense here. But I would say individually they played better than the Koreans for this map specifically. I think that their teamwork was actually pretty bad. I mean, their ults were just pretty bad. They wasted so many ults so many times. Where is this third-person shoulder stuff? Yeah, 6'9", that's crazy. Alright, let's talk comps. So now they have a Reinhardt. Makes sense. This makes sense to me. And Lunatic High does not... Oh no, they do have a Reinhardt. They're running triple tank, no Zarya. The execution of this comp, I guess, comes down mostly to how fast Unko can get his heals off, or like whether or not Unko can get his heals off. They don't have the best dive on Lunatic High. Like, there's not much pressure for Unko and Nox, because the only thing that can really dive them is the Winston. Everything else is pretty stationary. Rogue's comp on paper is pretty good against Lunatic Highs, because they have to come from the upper doorways. Like, this team can't jump you. This team has to walk up a staircase to get to you. So Rogue should, in theory, be able to hold upper right now. But it really comes down to Winds of Shields. There's a chance Lunatic High just rolls right through them with like superior spam. Reinforce gets hooked. Tavik just dives in, like whatever, doesn't care. Yeah, they're just gonna get rolled over now. That hook was really big. I don't know how he gets hooked there. Like, why was his shield down at all there to get hooked? Okay, so now Rogue is like really on the back foot. They're trying to delay. I don't mind, but they're gonna probably wind up feeding out here. Now they're feeding out, and they're not gonna probably get a good time for the bus. Like, now they really can't even defend the bus. Really big plays there. I feel like, yeah, I don't know if that was worth it. I feel like they should have just accepted the fact that they lost and just backed out. Because now this next fight, they switched off the Winston to the Zarya. That's really good. I like that. On the side of Lunatic High, Esca's getting in position right now to hit a high noon. They don't have the best interrupt. The only interrupt they have is Sleep Dart. They're gonna nano boost the high noon, which is really good. But it's gonna work. Got scouted, so that's really good for Rogue right now. Scouted the nano boost. But they have to go fight the cart right now, or I guess they can. It's too late. Ooh, that's sick. That was a sick play. You don't get a lot of that. They scouted it and they still got it off, which is really good, but they didn't have a counter to it. Like, they don't have a Roadhog on the side of Rogue. Like, unless Unko hits a Sleep Dart there, they don't win that fight. So, whatever, I guess. But that was really cool. You don't see that a lot. Like, that was just good execution. They put the McCree and the Ana up top, and nobody contested them. I mean, they saw them, but nobody contested, and then they wound up just, like, now boosting the high noon suddenly. Fight. So now Rogue's got Earth Shatter, they have Nano Boost, they have Graviton. So Rogue should be able to slow them down here. This is looking like a very fast time move for Lunatic High, but Lunatic High is not going to win this fight in an ideal world unless this is up. Esca going for the flank. Flank. They really want a Graviton here. Ooh, Esca, so good. Esca's making so much space right now, actually. Is it gonna be enough? Ooh, Esca missing shots. Esca, hello? Okay, so that just happened. That's one of those times in like Dota where you just spam like, that just happened. The chat wheel, because that shouldn't have happened. They won that fight without nano boost too, is the nice thing. So, yeah, that was a choke, I guess. Good sound barrier, I don't hate it. Ensures the or just like makes that high noon a little bit worse. A nano boost AKM there and he just got farmed in the inside of a Graviton. Big Earth Shatter from good counter Earth Shatter. That was really good Earth Shatter from Reinforced, but then he got counter Earth Shattered. But Tivik was there. So they're still putting in time. I mean, every second matters right now. If Tivik can get a Graviton here, not Graviton, if he can get Death Blossom here, they'll be okay, I think. That's really a big play from the two of them, though. All the stall is really good. This is probably one of the hardest points on the map to cap, or just in Overwatch to cap, I would say, because you have to go up that narrow street. And this corner is, like, super deceptively hard. Yeah, this isn't Twitch. This is on Yoku. I think it's like a 30 FPS stream, so if anyone's getting dizzy, it's not my fault. Panic ult? I feel like you knew you were going to die there. Graviton's still up. Winds needs to use it right now. Alright, there it is. There's just more time for them. They nano boost. That's, so they traded Graviton for nano boost. They should lose here, though. AKM just fearlessly aimbotting. Yeah, there was no way for them to win that. I feel like Tivik got a little too cocky there. But what's crazy actually is that none of that mattered. Like, now we're going back to another round of Numbani. This is now the fourth round of Numbani. Like, they're playing a best of seven on Numbani and they keep trading, and now this is the fourth map and someone has to win right now. They did a decent job of stalling the cart, but I think Tivik went a little too deep on that last nano boost. There's been some stellar McCree aim in the last 2 minutes, Kappa. I mean, yeah, AKM sitting his shots, like, that was pretty good. I mean, playing nano boost or just playing McCree into a nano boost of Reinhardt is like the most upsetting thing in the world, because your shots do like 20 damage and you're like, alright guys, I'm hitting headshots but they're doing 25, what am I supposed to do? Hello? Team? Everyone on Rogue's playing well. I just feel like their overall game plan is like a little sloppy. Eventually it's who throws the most. How long until they throw me into the next map? Come on, man. Come on, man. Alright, we're almost there. The Rogue has what, like a minute? Minute and 20? I don't know what their time was. I think it was like a minute and something. What is this? They're advertising alcohol? What? Organic oil? Is that funny because they're bots? Minute 5. So now they're like, alright guys, no funny business. Pretty divish comp. I mean, this is what they ran last time. They're just sticking with it. But I think it only worked last time because they got crazy diva value. This sleep dart, pretty big deal. This is what I expected to happen last time, is them just get ran over. Why aren't I on a pro team? Because I want to cast. I don't want to play on a pro team. I'd rather cast at this point, I think, honestly. Playing on a pro team is fun, but it's like not really that fun. It's a little stressful and a little like overwhelmingly time consuming. They don't get the kill. Esca's so good, actually. That was crazy. High noon? Why are you high noon? If Rogue gets this point, okay. Esco went from like having the biggest play in the world to just like growing. This is a sad Roadhog ult. They're just feeding. He like Li Taizhen staying alive for this long is kind of just feeding them ults. Like Rogue should be able to win this. Tuvik switches to Mei. I don't hate it. I think Mei is good. Actually, he's like surviving super long, to be honest with you. Are they gonna hold? Oh my god. I don't like their comp. Like, you knew that they were gonna run triple tank. Yeah, I don't know why he went sin ulted, but why? If you know that they're gonna run triple tank, and you only have a minute, why would you risk it with a D.Va? Do you really think D.Va is the best hero there? Like, would you not just rather run... I honestly think Mei would have been fine. I honestly think that anything would have been fine. I don't like D.Va. Like, D.Va didn't do anything for them. Ever. Like, D.Va getting kills... D.Va only worked on one push, and it was because, like, Esca stopped shooting it. Do I know the outcome? No, I don't know the outcome. I actually didn't. I know the score, I don't know the maps. And I don't actually know how the fights go, because I didn't watch it live at all. But why didn't they just go up and kill the Roadhog? Like, why did they let the Roadhog live for so long? I don't understand. Why did the Winston... Like, why didn't someone just go up and help him? I don't get it. I really don't get it. Hanzo honestly might have been better than D.Va. We'll never know, but they stuck with the D.Va so hard. I don't know why. If I were them though, I'd be so tired right now. Like, this is the equivalent of like playing 5 rounds of Anubis or something. I mean, Numbani is not that bad, but it's like up there on the list of like crazy maps that you can play, I guess, at any point in time. Just a hard hero to get kills with is D.Va. Like, is it really that good? I don't know. I don't think so. I just wonder why they wouldn't run something else. Hello, puppy. Come to watch videos. I expect the exact same. I mean, they have a very good win condition. They have 3 minutes to cap the first point. You should be able to do that. Tuvik's on Mei. I don't know why he wouldn't run Mei earlier. I like the Mei now, though. I think he just remembered Mei was a hero like 5 seconds ago or something. They're just spamming the shields right now. Neither team wants to commit. Good hook. Good wall. The wall was pretty bad, actually. The wall didn't wall him off. He has to instantly break the wall, and now they don't have wall for this next fight. They're trading on offense, which is really... This is working a little too well, honestly. I think Rogue's a little just out of their element now. I don't like AKM playing Roadhog, though. And Tuvik didn't execute that wall, which I think should have been a free kill. So, I mean, you mess up once. Yeah, GG. That was the longest drawn-out map I think I've ever seen in any game ever. So they hit a hook on Dean, AKM hit a hook, and then Tuvik tried to wall in the hook, but he missed it, and then the wall had to come down because it didn't block in the Reinhardt. It like saved the Reinhardt, so he had to drop it immediately. Must be difficult knowing that if you hold, you get to play Numbani for a third time. Yeah, I would probably lose on purpose at that point. I mean, obviously they wouldn't lose on purpose, but if they held and then they had to go to a third map of Numbani, someone would have been like, people would have been upset. Viewers would have been upset. Are you gonna watch the whole series? Yeah, dude. Yes, sir.